Hello, nerdlings!
What up, nerdlings?
What follows is our entire panel from MoGameCon.
This is our very first panel we've ever done, so be a little forgiving. We had a great time, we had so much fun, and this is for all of you who couldn't make it.
And we would like to extend a tremendous thank you to everyone at MoGameCon who gave us this opportunity to host our first panel. Thank you so much. All right, so we will begin. Can you hear us
or do we need the mic?
We can hear you.
Okay.
We will begin the auditions, so please come on up and
this is for Pitch Perfect 4.
I think there's, is there already one?
I don't know, is there already 4 out? I don't know.
So, I did want to say, before we officially start the panel, of course, keep in mind that this panel is happening at the same time as Pep the NES Punk, so anyone meant to be over there now is definitely in the jam, so I just wanted to make sure that we're all on the same page for that. But, most of you probably know, we are Do You Nerd. I am Tom. This is my wife, Lacey.
I'm Lacey.
And we are a YouTube couple who collect everything there is to collect. Because if we nerd it, if we like it.
We nerd it.
I always mess that up. That's why you start that one.
I usually always start that one if we like it.
So, honestly, the main focus for our panel was to encourage people to collect the things that they love. A fellow YouTuber of the name Discard, he has a great line, collect what you love, and we really want to steal that line from him because I don't think he needs that as much as we do. Because he's got some great display stuff, but we collect all the other stuff. And, we really want to kind of encourage people to not give up on flea markets and thrift shops because it can be really frustrating, especially going to yard sales. You go out there, you make like 20, 30 trips in a day, you don't find jack squat, but then there's one time that you do go and it kind of makes it worth the whole while. And what else did we have? We had some other things.
I was just going to say, I am not a person who has to know what something is. If I like it, literally, if I like it, I nerd about it, I will get it. I have bought so many toys, I have no idea who they are. I bought comics that I didn't know the storylines, but the cover looked cool, the toy looked cool, so it basically, you don't have to know what something is to collect it. If you like the way it looks, don't feel bad, just get it.
So here's my first page. This makes a lot more sense now. So this is my first panel, by the way.
Yeah, also you guys are, we're newbies at this. So,
but the reason we started our channel was because of all the stuff that we collect, all the stuff that we nerd out about. And especially on YouTube, we've really been part of a fantastic community. Mm-hmm. A couple of you people in here, you have been really great to us. You're always really positive. And it's really a lot of fun to be able to have these people to come together with and share those common interests with, especially when it is a positive community. And one of the things that we really wanted to do...
I'll just film the room a little bit there.
See, there's some people. Somebody actually likes us.
So what we wanted to do with our channel was show a lot of what we call closer-uppers, which is taking something and giving you a really in-depth look at it so that you can really get an idea. Is this something that I would be interested in? Whether it's a collectible, unboxing collector's editions, which a lot of people do that. But that can sometimes help you decide if you want to go after that one or maybe you want to go after the next one. Limited Run is a great example of that. A lot of people do unboxings for the Limited Run Collector's Editions. And on the one hand, I could see it feeling a little stale. But then on the other hand, it always helps me decide if that's one that maybe I would like to keep an eye out for at a convention. Or if, next time Limited Run puts a game out, it's like, maybe I'll take the time to really make sure that this is something that I want to look into. Maybe it's got something more than just, a soundtrack sampler. And we used to do a lot of unboxings as far as the monthly subscription boxes, because that was always a great way to see if it's worth your money to buy these things.
Beef up the collection of whatever.
Well,
you're doing.
Yeah.
Like I did a Funko Pop one, and so that beefed up my Funko Pop collection immensely.
That's true.
And Video Games Monthly is a great way to, if you don't have time to go game hunting, that's a great way to get games and a bunch of
yeah they don't
games.
They don't pay us, but they totally can. But in our area, Southwest Missouri, we don't always find the best of deals. I don't know how it is for everyone else, but it can sometimes be tough. You find you might find Tiger Woods 03 on the Wii, but you may not want to pay, you know, $9-$10 for it. It's like, you know, I'd still rather find that for like a buck or two at most. But the thing that I like about VGM is a lot of the games that we get, in all honesty, I would probably pass those by in the store. If I saw it on the store shelf, I may do that classic look at the label. You know, this guy's not beefy enough or anything. There's not enough explosions. I'm not going for this game. But whenever they send us games, it is nice because we sit down, we try them out, and it's like, oh, wow, I never would have picked this game up on my own. So that's kind of the point of doing the unboxings, to really kind of give those things a chance.
I was just going to say, the only time you get games that you don't know or care what the content is because I think the cover looks cool or the cartridge is a pretty color.
This is true.
I'm like, ooh, that one's red, that one's blue. I want that. I did that down on the floor, actually, today.
Yes. Yeah. Good. Just because of the color of the cartridge. Like, it's pretty.
Yep.
And then the other main thing that we really like to do for our channel is awareness, especially of local events, things like Renaissance festivals and conventions. In our area, we found a bunch of smaller conventions that probably not a lot of people know about. We've gone to Renaissance festivals that people have commented and said, you know, even though this RenFest has been here for 10 years, I just now found out about this. I can't believe this is happening. I live like an hour away. I would love to do this. And I think that's kind of a good thing because it's not always easy to follow up on a lot of these conventions. Things like MoGameCon is great, but it's still a one-day convention. It can be real easy to miss that in the blink of an eye. But,
or you think, oh, it's one day, I'm not gonna make the travel time to go see something like this.
Right, and whenever we try to do floor videos and everything, we really like to try to show off that convention. A lot of times people might do, you know, a quick panning shot of the games on hand, and that's great, I love seeing those. But without really seeing the floor, I can't get a good idea if it's worth the travel time. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah. And then so there have been occasions, like with the Ren Faire, for example. We went to a Ren Faire. They had no idea. There was no videos for it. I looked before we went. It was 3 hours from where we lived. It was Central Missouri Ren Faire. And there weren't any videos for it. So we went and we made sure to make a video of the whole thing so that people could see if it was worth going to. And this thing had been there for 10 years. And the next year we went, the people who run the thing actually came up to us and recognized us and said, you guys made a video, it was awesome, we love it, thank you so much. So, you know, it's also nice that to get that appreciation back for showing things off. So it's always good for awareness.
Right. And, you know, on that note, people, we get frequent comments saying that we're always doing something, and we usually are, but a lot of it is just to kind of encourage that, you know, get out there, find this stuff to do. There's a lot of stuff that you can miss out on that, you know, you might become a lifelong fan doing.
I don't know where we are in the notes.
Oh, I'm jumping.
Okay.
there, just over here.
So...
One of the things that we really wanted to touch on with this was collecting what you love. And, you know, especially when you come to a convention, there's no shortage of that. Whether it's games, if you like action figures, I've even seen some movies out there, you know, some box sets for shows and everything. And we like to push that because it's like, you know what you like to collect. And sometimes it can really be easy to fall into that stigma of, you know, well, there's all these people that collect video games. Maybe I should just collect video games. There's so many people collect comics. It's like, just find what you want to collect. And don't try to, you know, I guess, was it keep up with the Joneses? Because, it's no fun doing that. If you're going out and you're collecting video games, but you're not doing it because it's what you want to do, if you're doing it for, you know, I want to make sure that I get all the super expensive games or super rare games, you're kind of losing the point. There's a good chance for burnout from that. And then, you know, don't be discouraged by others, especially looking at other toy collections. I love pictures of people that have just started collecting, you know, toys, video games, whatever, when they have that smaller collection, because you can already start to see the passion of what they're collecting. You look in there and you see certain titles, you know, the Zeldas, the Final Fantasies, you know they're obviously an RPG fan. But watching how that collection grows is always a lot of fun. I get a kick out of that. I think you do with the toys.
Yeah.
Because there's everything. Yeah. Toys for everything.
There's toys for everything. I was going to say, with the collect what you love, don't feel pressured to collect at a fast pace. Just because you want to get into something doesn't mean you have to immediately get everything and start collecting and collect. You can collect two items in 5 years and you're still doing the collecting thing. You're still getting what you want and what you need. And, you know, it's there's no race. There's just, you know, some people don't have the money to go out and buy every single game they see. You know, you can spend $5 here, $5 there, you know.
You have $5 I could spend?
Yeah. You can have $5 more. That's it down there. Sweet. That's it, though.
Totally winning this challenge now. but, you know, that is a good point. Not being pressured by how long it takes you to build up that collection. Because, you know, we get a lot of nice comments about, you know, the collections that we have, whether it's the games or the toys and everything.
It's like 10 years
It's taken a lot of time.
And a lot of restarts.
And a couple of restarts, but then, you know, sales. Sales are our friends. Even places like Vintage Stock. We don't usually go to Vintage Stock just because of the pricing. It's a little higher than what we would like. But man, whenever they're having their sales, the buy two, get one, oh yeah, that's the perfect time to go. And whenever they're having sales like that, the toys, which she goes nuts for,
they're always 33%
off. So that's nice. And, you know, so as far as not feeling pressured, I mean, that collection could be as big or small as you want it. Yeah. You know, whether you want to collect all the NES games or it's like, I'm just going to collect GameCube games.
Well, because I've known people that, you know, well, I haven't picked up anything in like 5 years. Well, that doesn't matter. You're still collecting. You're still a collector. If you only have two items of something, you're a collector.
The next point that kind of we wanted to touch on, you know, just to encourage that collecting vibe, is collect for the reason that you want to. And we kind of touched on that in the first one, as far as not trying to keep up with people, but then also collecting the stuff that you want to collect. You know, instead of going after those high-priced games, you know, if you love, I don't know, you might be some like weird dude that's like totally into LJN games, and that would be the perfect thing to collect. But it's because you like it. And it's admirable when people do that because they don't let anyone steal their shine, basically. Like, look, I don't care what you think. I'm collecting these games. But that's what's really cool about seeing it in a collection, at least for me. I love seeing that. But maybe you're a completionist and you're a sucker for all the variants or all the colored cartridges because you've got to have a Famicom Rainbow.
Hey, they were a lot more inventive than we are.
You know, on that note, one of the things that really got her into comic collecting was just going off of the covers. Mm-hmm. And I've seen a lot of comic book collectors who aren't really big on that. And they're like, that's fine. But, you know, you really need to get, like, the story. You got to get, like, the whole storyline, but then you also have to get this one issue for that one turning point. But at the same time, these collectors will also be the same ones that turn around and start showing off their art germ cover collections. And it's like, well, you know, granted it still may be a great Wonder Woman story, but you set out and you bought that comic just for that cover. So what's the difference between just picking up a comic for the cover? And, you know, again, that just kind of goes along with the whole, you know, collect for the reason you want to. I mean, comic covers alone, even if you're not reading the books, it's like just put them on the wall. They're great pieces of art. They look wonderful.
Yeah. That's the whole point of the cover. The same thing with a video game. The whole point of the cover is to get you interested into it. So I don't think there's anything wrong with collecting just for pretty sake.
And then moving on to collecting how you want to. And that comes down to, again, sometimes it can be tough in collecting groups because a lot of people are only interested in completed box collections. And, you know, they don't want anything to do with loose cards and stuff. But then a lot of people just want to play the games. And, you know, it's nice to push that if you're going to collect video games, you don't have to go for the completed box. You don't have to go for, you know, the rarest ones. It's like, again, just collect how you want to. If you want this game and you just want to play it and don't care about the condition with it, I thought it was VGM that used to give away, like, their trash games. It'd be games that just had, you know, like, trash covers or something would be wrong with the cartridge, the plastic would be broken, and they would give them away because the game still works. And so it was for people that just wanted to play the game. And I think that's always, you know, kind of a tough hurdle to get over. because it ties into comics and action figures. You know, so many people don't want action figures unless it's complete in a box, sealed, never opened, you know, from 1973, or the same thing with comics. Again, they're kind of throwing that whole storyline aside, even though they push that, because now they just want this really, you know, pristine issue of a comic. And it's like, you know, if you're collecting comics, it doesn't really matter if you have the nicest looking comic, if you just want that comic. At least that's how we look at it. And that's part of what, you know, helps build our collection.
The other thing is if you want that complete in box, but you are okay with it not being the same complete in box, that is the perfect way to collect something, because you can buy the loose cart here, you can buy the box here, you can buy the manual here, put it all together, and then you've got the complete in box, but you only spent maybe $20 versus $300 or something. As long as you are okay, which we are, we don't have a problem, like, you know, Frankensteining things together to get that complete box of whatever, whether it's a toy, a, you know, video game, mm-hmm. or a video game system, or any, I mean, you can't really do comics necessarily. They don't really, covers don't really fly around with the rest of it, but, you know, you might.
You know, if I find, like, just a cover, I'm just going to tape it to whatever comic I want. Or, like, an awesome Catwoman cover.
Isn't that what, like, kids do to, like, be reading the comic, but they've got their, like, grade, their school
book. Ooh la la! Ooh la la!
Did you get that reference? No.
So another thing that our channel does is, or at least that we attempt to do with our channel, is awareness. Like I said before, awareness of where to go to find this stuff. You know, the flea markets, yard sales, pawn shops. That's why we like to do the pickup videos. Again, I know that those are another dime a dozen videos, but it's always good to keep showing those, that it's like there can be stuff out there. You do have to be diligent. You really have to work at it. But to find those good deals, they are out there. And we try to throw in tips. A lot of other channels, I think, probably do it better. But, you know, looking through CDs to look for that one game that's in there. Like all these music CDs.
Because they'll mix in CDIs or
right.
PlayStations or Dreamcast.
I mean, the few Dreamcast games I think I've found more often than not mixed in with the CDs, the music CDs.
Yeah.
And it sucks, though. You go to some of these thrift stores and there's like stacks and stacks, and it takes forever just to scan through them. But you find that one Dreamcast game. Out of the blue, you find a TurboGrafx game. I think I found Tricky Kick that way. So it could have been a better TurboGrafx game, but it was still mixed in. Things like half-price books is a great place. A lot of people have been talking about that lately, because sometimes some places will have games, but it's also a great place to go for game guides. And people have started to collect those. And places like half-price books, they usually don't take that stuff in unless it looks really somewhat nice, you know, so you're
comics.
Not getting something, you know, tore apart. Yeah, graphic novels.
Yeah.
We found a whole slew.
I don't know if elsewhere does it, but in our area, we have a Friends of the Library sale where the library will sell some of their old stuff because they've got new books in. They'll get a bunch of other people. And, you know, a lot of people don't know that the library has comics or graphic novels, and you can check them out. And then when they're, you know, they cycle them out and everything. So Friends of the Library sales are always great for things like that. And, you know, I was going to jump back where you said, you know, they're dime a dozen for those videos, but there are new people out there who are just started collecting, and they may just have stumbled upon your YouTube channel. And so I don't see any problem with doing something that a bunch of other people do. Like, before we started doing this, I never thought to go to Goodwill for video games. You know, I know a lot of people out there do know that, but there are some people who don't know. Some people don't know you go to a flea market or a thrift store for these things. So, you know, that kind of stems back to the awareness thing for people who just started collecting. They don't know where to go necessarily.
On that note, it can be good to a degree when these videos are a dime a dozen, because you might stop talking about them in your videos, because I've mentioned 50 times that I go to this place. I don't need to keep mentioning it. But again, if someone is just tuning into your channel, they may not think to look at these places and stuff like that. And then another awareness, of course, like we said, was for local events and events, activities, festivals. Again, people often don't know that those are going on. I don't know if sometimes there's maybe too much reliance on social media, but it doesn't seem like there's a lot of promotion for events outside of that. And I get that social media is probably the best place to promote these, but sometimes that word doesn't get around. We've stumbled upon Ren Fairs and conventions just alone. Literally just, you know, we're driving down a road and there's a sign that goes into a field, and we actually didn't get murdered because there was a Renaissance Festival.
Or did we? This is a really weird limbo.
But the same with conventions.
Thank you for all joining our limbo.
The same with conventions. Our library center in town, we went in one day and we were literally there just to, you know, check out some books, and there were all these people in cosplay walking around. It's like, what's going on? And come to find out, they had been doing this yearly library con. And the nice thing was, typically whenever one convention is set up, you'll have booths and tables talking about other conventions. So, you know, from there, we would start, well, we knew about Game, but we would learn about like Moon City, but just a bunch of other conventions that would either focus on tabletop gaming was a big one. And then some of the others. Well, one was for Dragon Fest.
Yeah, for Dragon Fest, which is a small Renaissance fair. Well, it's not small anymore. It was when we went. Now it's 3 years later. We found out about it wasn't necessarily, was it a tabletop convention in Bolivar?
It was kind of a free-for-all.
But it was just in a school library, and it was just like three or four booths, but it's, you know, it was kind of fun. We found a new game that we never knew, bought it and took it home and everything. So,
you know, for those reasons and for others, we always encourage people to get out, find these conventions, because especially coming to a place like this, it's a great way to network. Mm-hmm. You know, if you do have a channel, or if you're wanting to find other channels, it's a great place to find those things. You know, find more viewers, or, you know, find channels that you didn't know about before. And it's, you know, it's just fun to get together with like-minded people and, you know, maybe have like a little gaming challenge, you know, trying to find like the best thing or something, you know, right here, just saying it's on camera, it's official, but it's a great way to share your collection with people, you know, and, you know, show them like, oh yeah, you know, this I'm interested in, but, you know, maybe they weren't really interested into that or in that until they got to see it firsthand. And so you already talked about the library con. And then just to touch on it again, doing the videos showing whether or not it's worth your time to come to these conventions, especially the ones that, you know, if you're driving a long way just to get to them, you know, kind of want to start to think, well, would I want to do this again next year? And like she had said before, some of the Renaissance festivals, it's incredible for the number of people that go to these festivals. They go, they dress up, they partake in all of the activities there. You know, they're drinking, they're jousting, they're yelling, they're not really brawling because they frown on that.
Let's face it, most of the guys go for that. The sword racks of the ladies.
It's a great way to sell swords when a busty girl is saying, look at, you know,
look at my rack.
Please look at my rack.
There's a sword.
I have swords for sale.
Right there. That's why we know all the guys go. That's not lie.
But it is incredible. You know, despite the number of people that get into these things and go to these things, when you look online, it can sometimes be so hard to find anything for them. And, you know, again, maybe some panning shots of MoGameCon, but, well, how big is the place? Mm-hmm. You know, how much space does it take up? How much room is actually there for, you know, for the vendors, for the celebrity guests that they bring in and stuff like that? Do they have something set up to actually do gaming? You know, sit down, play some games, try some stuff out. At least that's what I'm always looking for when I'm trying to find stuff on conventions.
I want to know if there's going to be toys.
And then pretty much the last bit, I don't know what we're doing on time.
It's 12:43 or something. Not 40, 12:23. Sorry. I jumped ahead, way ahead. The next panel starts at 12:45.
So, 43? Oh my gosh.
No.
What's going on?
We're supposed to be done at 12:30 so that they have 15 minutes to set up if they need 15 minutes.
One of the big things that we do try to push on our channel
is
the awareness of the community and positivity with an emphasis for online. Because, you know, if I may shout you guys out, Gaming Off the Grid, Captain Algebra, Batfan, these guys are all part of our community that we've gotten to know online, and they've always been ridiculously positive, you know, in talking to, working with, and, you know, a lot of these guys were meeting for the first time coming to this convention, you know, first time meeting in person. And it's so great because after, like, every time we would meet up with someone, it's like, okay, so what'd you think of them in real life? And it's like, you know what? We spend so much time watching their videos and talking to them. It doesn't feel like we just met them. You know, it's like, oh, yeah, you know, we saw them, you know, 2 days ago. It's on a video, but, you know, we still saw you 2 days
ago. My only comment ever is, they're taller than I thought. Which is not hard for me, because I'm really short. But I often wonder, do people go, oh my gosh, she's shorter than I thought. But I don't know if I'm short sitting next to him, because we don't stand a whole lot. But
but on that note, you know, that's one of the things that we really love about this community because of how positive everybody is. And we really try to do that. We try to encourage people to, you know, collect despite all the hardships of, you know, not finding deals, not having good places to go. Maybe conventions are, you know, too few and far between in your area. Maybe they're just, you know, way too far away. GC. We'll try. But, you know, encouraging people to, you know, discard, collect what you love, because you should be out there just collecting
He's
the things that you like,
say it's ours.
But having fun with it and everything, and knowing that there are so many people out there that share the same interests as you, and encouraging them then, you know, if you have the chance to find these events, to go to these events, to go meet up with these people, you know, you have so much fun with them. They're ridiculously great to hang out with and everything. And, you know, to keep pushing that positivity in the online community as far as letting people know, hey, you know what? You just started this collection. You've got five NES games. They're all like super common games. That's awesome. That is a great way to start. You know, check this game out. Look at, I think Jaws is pretty common, you know. I see that you have Jaws. You know what?
That was a game I wanted to look for down there. I forgot about that.
But that's a fairly easy game to knock out, you know? And it's like, here, play that game. Sit down, knock it out. You're going to feel really good because it's like, oh, I've got this collection going. I've already knocked one of these games out. No problem. And, you know, as far as, like, the encouragement of the community, Captain Algebra, he streamed the game The Little Mermaid, and it encouraged her to play this game, to revisit this.
I encouraged him
this.
To play it, though. Well, it was a request night, so I requested it, but it made me, because I played it as a kid, and I remember it being super hard, and I didn't want to finish it, and then I watched him, asked him to play it, he played it, and I was like, I could do that, and then I realized I was, like, at the end when I was a kid, like, I think I had one more screen, and that was the end boss, so I was like, well, great, but, so yeah, it encouraged me to finish it.
Of course, you make all games always look so easy anyway. So, you know, no death run, super C, got G. Come on, guys.
We're good.
But, you know, we do try to encourage, you know, that positivity towards people in their collections and try to, you know, like, cut out that jealousy of other people, you know, with their collections. Like, don't be jealous of other people's collections. A fairly new YouTube channel, Retro Rick. If you guys have watched any of his stuff, I mean, he's got great production values. He's got a really great personality. But his backdrop, the stuff that he has in his collection, it's like, oh, it kind of hurts, some of the stuff that he has. But it's also nice to know that the way that this guy knows the stuff, he really has a passion for it. So it's like, well, it's in a really good home. I mean, it'd be in a good home. In our home, too, just saying. But it's kind of that push of, instead of, you know, dropping dislikes and being like, oh, yeah, you've got all this stuff, you know, I'll never get this, you know, screw your video, you know, just pop it in there and being like, oh, hey, you know, I see that you've got this thing in the background. The only thing I see is like a turquoise table or something back there. So
it's a jazzercise thing.
Retro Rick, you got this jazzercise thing. Let's see more of that. But, you know,
I thought you were talking about in this room, actually.
I was.
This is going very strange.
But, you know, just kind of pushing, you know, it's like not being jealous of other people's collections and everything because, you know, like you guys getting off the grid. I love all of your games. Like, they look fantastic on the shelves. They really do. They look really nice. And I mean, all the stuff that you guys are always picking up, it's like, okay, I see where all the deals are. That's fine. Okay, you know, next couple of towns over, whatever, fine.
There's no reason to be mean, honestly.
Well, no, there isn't.
There is no reason. It doesn't, I mean, I know in the short term it makes you feel better about yourself, but, you know, you could say something to someone and they're so insecure about their collection that it makes them quit collecting. You know, so there's no reason to be mean to anybody.
Right.
Just say a nice thing, because it's not going to hurt you to say something nice.
You know, on that note, too, something that we actually like to do is check in on other YouTubers, especially like with Twitter and everything. Sometimes you'll see that someone's having a rough day and dropping them a message. I won't name drop him just out of respect, but there was someone that on Twitter, he was having a really rough time. He was talking about how he hadn't posted a video for a while because he was going through a lot of personal stuff. And he was apologizing to us, his viewers, for this. And I sent him a private message. I said, man, you know, you do not have to apologize for that. This stuff is way more serious than these videos and checking in on us. You know, we will be here. When you're ready to come back, we'll be here for you. And he actually came back and, you know, he started talking about, you know, in more in depth about what was going on. And I think it was nice for him to have that outlet, you know, just someone to talk to and to feel like, you know, he wasn't being judged for not making videos. And sometimes, you know, just having that positive vibe in the community, checking in on these people, because these people are your friends. They're, you know, they're your like-minded people. They're your nerdlings.
Yeah.
Because if anyone is into the stuff that we're into, there are nerdlings,
mm-hmm.
because that's what we are. We're nerds. We nerd out about this stuff. We do nerd.
I was going to say, on that note, you have no idea what's going on in people's lives. They may not be out talking about it or letting people know what's going on. And so, you know, if you do say something not nice to them or whatever, it just sets it off even more. So, you know, just...
domino affects it.
Yeah.
And, you know, as far as that positivity goes... we try to be positive in our channel, and we try to be very nice, and we try to curb our language and everything to be as family friendly
yeah,
as possible.
We
want to
be
because,
everybody's
you know,
show.
Like when we go to conventions, one of the things that we love is cosplayers. You know, everyone always looks so incredible. The time that they put into these outfits and everything, and the way they get into character, it's great. But then when you see like the kids in cosplay, or just the kids responding to the cosplayers,
oh my gosh, it's great.
Running up to them because it's like,
there's Spider-Man
not,
right
yeah,
there
you're
in front
not
of me.
Dressed up as Spider-Man. You are Spider-Man.
That was me last week.
Yeah, it looks so you know, we try to keep that in mind with our channel and everything. You know, maybe some people know that that's we're not always that squeaky clean.
Last night I let something slip.
But
on a live
is,
stream, first time the internet heard me say a bad word. Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. I'll help you out.
Don't say
furthermore, but no, we do just try to keep it clean because we do want as many people to get in there and be as encouraging
yeah.
to people, you know, to get out there. And
I actually take pride in the fact that anyone at any age can watch our show, and we try very, very hard not to offend anybody. And we are both, you know, larger than life personalities. We have major opinions, and we have major opinions about things that are going on. But we try to not even deal with stuff like that. You know, this is our channel. We're just talking about nerdy stuff, and that's it. You know, we don't want anything else on it. We want anyone to be able to watch it, so.
We also go to some events that might not be suitable for the channel, so we don't make videos of those.
Which I'm sure some people would prefer, like when we go to the burlesque shows. We check in at the burlesque shows, though. We do check in at the burlesque shows, as do you, nerd. We just don't turn the camera around to show what's on stage.
All right, well, so that was the panel, and be sure to like, comment, subscribe down below. This is normally when it...
Don't forget to, you know, like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We got merch on TeePublic, and nerds if we like it.
We nerd it.
There.
I got that. Well, thank you.
I'll try to take a... We'll turn around and take it if I can get my camera.
Give me
a selfie with everybody behind us.
Attached
to the chair. All right. So, we see the hole. Did everybody?
Here, look at the camera.
All right.
Now, I don't know how much more time we're on now.
I don't know what time is it. It's 12:39. So I guess...
Probably. Anyone does have any questions.
Yeah, does anybody have any questions or anything they want to say?
You guys want to be like, you know, the whole talk about not collecting completed box stuff. You guys are dumb. Let's get it. And not listening to that.
I appreciate the not using profanity, because this one's starting to learn words.
And it's only...
You don't have to worry about it.
It's only cute like the first two or three times, and then it's like, okay.
When they start using it in the right context, that's when it gets scary.
Well, thank you guys very much.
Thank you very, very much.
And, I will apologize personally to Pat that you guys were not in his panel, because I know he's going to call every one of you out. But again, thank you guys so much. We really appreciate it.
We appreciate you coming to this side, to the left side.
We'd like to say a big, big thank you to those of you who came and participated and stayed in the panel and listened to us ramble on about everything that we like to nerd out about.
Yes. You know, most of the people that were in there are actually all of our YouTube friends. And the fact that they came and stuck it out through our panel, even though there were other panels going on, that really means the world to me. And having that group of people in there meant a lot more to me than having a packed room with standing room only. So, guys, thank you so much for being so supportive and being there for us.
And thank you to the people who didn't know who we were that came to check us out.
Absolutely. Thank you guys as well.
We appreciate that, too. And MoGameCon, if you ever want us to come back and do another panel, we would love it, because if we like it...
We nerd it.